Right now, some comments we've been watching very closely. Federal Reserve Chairman Jerome Powell speaking at an annual economic summit in Jackson Hole, Wyoming. It's a speech drawing extra attention as investors trying to gauge just how much the Fed could raise interest rates next month and after.
Let's bring in CNN business correspondent Rahel Solomon for the latest. What stands out to you from what the Fed chair just said moments ago?
Well, Poppy and Jim, it was certainly a very short speech, just about 8 minutes in duration. But I think investors heading into this, and traders and economists around the world, were looking for direction in terms of where are we in this inflation-fighting effort from the Fed, and they got it. Chairman Powell was very aggressive in terms of where we are and where we're heading. Take a listen to some of the comments he made just a few minutes ago.
Reducing inflation is likely to require a sustained period of below-trend growth. Moreover, there will very likely be some softening of labor market conditions. While higher interest rates, slower growth, and softer labor market conditions will bring down inflation, they will also bring some pain to households and businesses. These are the unfortunate costs of reducing inflation. But a failure to restore price stability would mean far greater pain.
So what's he saying there? He's saying that the Fed expects there to be some softening in the labor market, i.e. joblessness. He said that we're going to see inflation likely higher for longer. He said that we'll also see, of course, borrowing costs continue to rise as the Fed raises its benchmark interest rate. He also addressed the fact that we have started to see, including this morning, inflation reports that indicated some easing. And to that point, he said, look, the lower inflation readings for July are a welcome, but a single month's improvement falls far short of where the committee will need to see before we are confident that inflation is moving down. And my read from that, Jim and Poppy, is we're not there yet. They're not done with raising rates. And so we know we have a meeting in about a month, still unclear whether we will see the Fed raise rates by half a percentage point or three quarters of a percentage point. There are more meetings this year, but it is very clear from the Fed's messaging there is that we're not done. We're going to see rates continue to increase because we're not where we need to be, according to the Fed, in terms of lowering inflation.
A major slide on Wall Street. The Dow, as you can see there, down about 1,000 points. This after a sobering assessment today from the Federal Reserve Chairman Jerome Powell. Taming inflation, Powell warns, will require some pain. Let's get straight to CNN business correspondent Rahel Solomon. So Rahel, Powell's warning really led to a jolt on Wall Street. That's a pretty significant drop.
Yet really spooking Wall Street and Main Street in terms of the messaging we heard here. And to put this in perspective, Erica, we haven't seen a day like this in the market since mid-June. Every sector in the S&P 500 closed lower today. So it was a broad-based sell-off as investors really parsed through what Federal Reserve Chairman was trying to get across. He talked about the fact that the Fed will not stop raising interest rates until they are confident. He said, Chairman Powell said, we will keep at it until we are confident the job is done. The job, of course, being lowering inflation. But the concern that's being felt in the markets is that when it's all said and done, we will likely be in a very different place economically in terms of consumer spending, in terms of the labor market. And the fear is that we are much more likely now heading toward a recession. Every time the Fed has to be more aggressive in terms of rate hikes, it increases the likelihood of a policy misstep. And that's what you're seeing in the markets today.